Hello and welcome to another session on Cisco WebEx. In this video, I am going to show you how you can check attendance and attentiveness of students during online lecture and how to generate attendance report in Cisco WebEx. So, in this video, we will see how to check the attentiveness of students, how to generate attendance record in Cisco WebEx, how to export attendance record in Excel format, and how to organize the attendance record as per roll number. Now, suppose I have conducted a lecture and I want to check the attendance record. It is very easy to get the attendance record in WebEx. Sometimes we are also interested to know whether the student is attentive. Because many times during online events, it may happen that a student may join the WebEx session for only attendance purpose. And then he may minimize the screen of WebEx and work on some another app. So in WebEx, we have a facility to check the attentiveness of the students also. So let us see how we can do that. So before we start, let me tell you that this is a third part on how to use Cisco WebEx for online teaching. If you haven't seen first two parts, then I suggest you to first watch those parts. In first part, we have seen how to schedule an event on WebEx, that is how to generate the link for your lecture and share it with the students using event option. In second part, I have tried to show you how actually you can conduct an online lecture using a PowerPoint presentation on WebEx and how to share the files and videos during your online lecture. Now, in this third part, we will study how to check the attendance and attentiveness of the students. So, let us start. So, first of all, you have to log in into your WebEx account. Suppose you want to generate the record consisting of first name, last name, and roll number of the students. Then first, while scheduling your lecture, you have to add appropriate fields in the register option. So actually this I have already explained in part one. So let us see how to add the additional fields. So in for that, you schedule your lecture in event option. So in event option, if you click on this event option, schedule an event option, then here you can write the appropriate fields, write the event name, start date, start time, etc. Then you scroll down here. Here you have the option of register. Registration form. So first you click on this, uncheck all. So you will get the data, first name, last name, email address. Now I want roll number also. So I can add here text box and write here roll number and then save. Click this, check this box also. So it will be a compulsory field while registering the event. Then save and close. So in this way, you can add first name, last name, and roll number in your attendance record. Now, whatever field you add in your registration form, all these fields will appear in your attendance record. Okay, now I will explain you how we can check the attentiveness of the students. So let me close all this. Now suppose I have started my session and I want to check whether the students are attentive or not. So here you can see Here we have option of participants. So click here on participants. So you can see what are the students who are attending your class. So here you can see there is one attendee. I will magnify this. So here attendee one and one host. So if I click on view all attendee, you can see here there is one attendee. I am using my mobile to attend this session. Just observe here. I am now in session. I am attending the session, and now I am minimizing my WebEx screen on mobile. So let us see what are the changes here. So if the student minimize the WebEx screen and use some other app, you can see here this exclamation sign, red color. So if the student is not attentive, you can see this exclamation sign in front of that student, and hence you can check the attentiveness of that student. Then at that point you can unmute the student's microphone and ask him some question or interact with the student. So this is how we can check the attentiveness of the student. We can also check the attentiveness of student in attendance report, which is generated by Cisco WebEx. So there are two ways to check the attentiveness. One is from this participants option here. You can see the participants, and if there is red sign here, that means the student is not attentive, he is using some other screen. And second way is we can generate the report in the Cisco WebEx, and we can also check the attentiveness from the report generated by the Cisco WebEx. In WebEx, attendance report is not generated immediately after the end of the class. Normally, reports will be available approximately 30 minutes after the end of the session. Now, suppose you have conducted lecture, the report is generated by WebEx, and now you want to view and download the report. Now what you can do is to click on My WebEx. Then you go to My Reports. Now here you scroll down, because we have scheduled our session through WebEx event. So go to WebEx event. Here you click on attendance report. So you can see here the note here. You can generate reports for only dates up to 3 months prior to today. So here, suppose I have conducted a lecture on 10th of the August. So I will write here 10th August. And display report. Now here, you will get a consolidated list of lectures you conducted on that particular date. Here you can see how many students have attended the lecture. So 70 students have attended that lecture on 10th of August. So if you click on this 70 here, it will ask you whether you want to send a thank you email message to all the 70 attendees. So if you click on this send, then all the student will get a thank you email on their thank you message on their email. So let us see what is that message. If you click on this thank you, you can see here it will send a message like this: thank you for attending web seminar. Here there will be a topic name, date here, and here there will be your name and your email ID. Now let us see how to get detailed attendance report. For that, you have to click on this event name. I want an attendance report for this lecture. So click on this. So you will get here some couple of things for individual students. So what was the event ID? When the event started at 11 a.m. What is the event end time? What was the name of that student? Ayushi. What is email ID? What is first name? What is last name? For individual student, you will get individual data. But we are not interested in such type of report. So this is not useful for keeping the attendance record of the students. So we can also get the information in tabular format. So you can export the report in Excel format. So for that, you have to click on this export. So if you click on this export, the file will be downloaded here. Click on that file. When you will open this file, it will look like this. It is very complicated and there is lots of information in this file. So we don't want all the information. So here we can see attendance, event ID, the program name, first name, last name, email ID, what is the percentage attendance, etc., etc., on the sheet. But we are not interested in all the data. We want only first name, last name, and roll number. So who were present for our class? Actually, only 70 students have attended the class. But you can see here, we have total 113 entries. There are multiple entries for few students. So you can, if you observe here, for example, this Yash Pinjani, you can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 entries are there. So this may be due to internet connectivity issues or any other issue. So if there are multiple entries, then we have to remove these multiple entries. So let us see how we can remove the multiple entries and how we can sort this data and arrange this data properly. So for that, first I will remove all the fields which are not required. I will keep only first name and last name and roll number, because I don't want other fields. So now I have removed all the unnecessary field. I want only first name, last name, and student's ID. Now you can see here, there are multiple entries for the students. Total there are 70 students, but we have entry up to 113 entries are there. And also these IDs are not as per the sequence. Now I want to sort this. So for that, first, I will remove all the unnecessary extra entries in this. So I will select this. Now I have selected all the entries. Now you can go to data. Here there is remove duplicates. So click on this. Now I will uncheck this column A and column B. I will check only column C where there are multiple entries of the roll number. So if I click on only C and click on OK, then you can see here only 70 students are there now. All the multiple entries are deleted. Once you remove all the duplicate entries, you can see here this is not as per the sequence. Now we want to arrange this as per the roll number. So for that, you can click on this sort, sort by column C, and then OK. OK. You can see here now this is rearranged as per the roll number. So in this way, we can generate the student's attendance record and we can check the attentiveness of the students. So for each day, you can make a separate sheet here and you can keep the record in one file. And then after that, you can compile that data. Now, suppose you want to rearrange this data. First of all, select this student ID column. Right click, cut, and take it to column A. Select column A. Then again, right click, and you have the option insert cut cell here. So click on that. Now this data is rearranged. So in this way, we can arrange our attendance data in proper sequence. So this is all for now. Stay connected. Thank you for watching this video. If you like the video, share and like the video. Thank you very much.